Hi everyone, I am Astha and today I'm going to talk to you briefly about the Roblox data scientist interview process. At the end of this video, you should have a good understanding of the process itself, what the interviewers are filtering for, and several tips on preparing yourself for this. Now, after covering the process, I will talk about one specific interview round tip that is unique to Roblox and how to get through it. First, a quick intro. I am from Prepfully and this overview has been put together by Roblox data scientists who are also interview coaches on Prepfully and the very same ones who have helped hundreds of candidates with mock interviews and advice. Now, this is a video version of our much more in-depth written guide, which we link within the description. And you can always book time with the coaches directly for more personalized guidance on Prepfully's website. Right, onto the overview now. As a part of the Roblox data scientist interview, the candidate, that is you, will need to go through three primary rounds. The first is a recruiter screen. The second round consists of multiple interview rounds. And the final round of the interview process at Roblox involves an on-site interview. Now let's talk about step one first, that is the recruiter screen. This stage is divided into two rounds, a phone screening with a recruiter, followed by a phone screening with a hiring manager. Now, phone screening with the recruiter. During this round, the recruiter will go through your resume and ask you questions about your previous experience in data science. You will also be asked to discuss one of your previous projects and your roles in it. The recruiter will be looking to get a general understanding of your background, your skills, and your experience. Phone screen with the hiring manager. This phone screening will be an opportunity for the hiring manager to get more details about your background and to introduce you to the team and the position details. Now, the hiring manager will ask you questions about your experience and qualifications and how they relate to the role of a data scientist at Roblox. We have five tips for getting through this round. Be super familiar with your past work. Make sure that you have a project that you can talk about from each one of your previous roles. Organize your thoughts in advance around topics like what was your contribution, how did things go down when you were there, and what could you have done better. Keep your answers short and crisp. Have a clear reason to why you're applying at Roblox as well as why you think you'd succeed there. This round often starts with the old favorite, tell me a little bit about yourself. So it is always useful to have a nice short intro ready to roll on with. Next up is step two. The second round consists of multiple interview rounds, and some of the rounds you can expect to face are a coding challenge. This round is a coding challenge that tests the candidate's SQL skills. It includes multiple choice questions and requires you to write SQL code to solve the problems. This challenge helps assess your knowledge of SQL and ability to write code to extract the data and perform analysis. ML interview. Now, this round is an ML interview which is focused on the candidate's knowledge of machine learning. Now, some candidates reported being asked product case questions to test their ability to apply machine learning techniques to real-world problems. Online assessment games. This round is a series of online assessment games that test the candidate's cognitive abilities. There are three types of games. We will talk more about this unique round before the end of the video. We have two tips for this round. Be familiar with supervised and unsupervised learning algorithms and be able to provide examples on each. Brush up on your SQL skills and be prepared to write code to extract data and perform analysis. This step is often the one with the highest drop-off rate since candidates often get caught off guard by the breadth of the questions which can come up. We'd strongly recommend practicing with someone who can assess how you actually come across in a real interview. So get a friend to help you with a mock or just use a coaching service like Prepfully's, where a data scientist can simulate that real interview vibe for you and provide specific feedback on how you did. Now, the third and the final round of the interview process at Roblox involves an on-site interview. This interview is focused on evaluating the candidate's behavior and past experiences. This is also an opportunity for the interviewer to get a more in-depth understanding of the candidate's personality, the work style and how they approach problem solving. The interviewer may ask questions about the candidate's previous work experiences, leadership skills, and how they have dealt with challenging situations in the past. This round is critical in determining the candidate's fit with the company culture and whether they have the skills and experience necessary to excel in this role. Now, here are some tips for this round. Come up with a list of questions you have about the team and the position that you are interviewing for. Prepare to discuss product case questions and your approach to solving them. Last but not the least, the promised bit of advice on Roblox's unique interview round is the online assessment games Test Your Cognitive Abilities. Let us give you an example of a game that a candidate faced, selecting infected animals or building cars to reach the destination through multiple barriers. One tip we would like to give you for this round is prepare to discuss your approach to the online games, including any strategies that you might have used to optimize your performance. Good. Now that is all from us. Once you feel ready for some practice or just want a sense check of your preparation level, especially on custom rounds such as the online games assessment one, you can book an anonymous mock interview with a data scientist from Roblox on Prepfully. We have included a link for the same in the description below. In addition to that, I have also linked a bunch of useful resources for you in the description, most of which are free. There is a written guide, there are several interview questions, and if you have follow-up questions about the interview, ask in the comments below. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.